Students at Garrett Heights Elementary-Middle School are looking at zebrafish. They are hoping the fish will mate and produce embryos. The students are engaged in a project called BioEYES.
BioEYES is a science outreach education program that was started in 2002. It was started by Dr. Steve Farber, and he was a scientist up at Thomas Jefferson University at the time. And he wanted to improve science in schools. And so he founded BioEYES, and it's a program that uses live fish. We bring fish into schools, and we really want to excite kids about science. And the fact that we use live organisms helps us to do that.
Where's it?
She may have some, because ours is really skinny.
I knew mine.
It has an inner tank that has holes in the bottom. That's going to go inside the outer tank. Now, why do you think we would want to have holes in the bottom?
For the eggs.
For the eggs, exactly. So this is big enough for the eggs to fall through. So why would we want to separate the eggs from the adults? In the way in the back.
Because the adult fish might eat them.
That's true.
Valerie Butler is the program manager for the BioEYES project and is one of three outreach workers that takes the program to students in city schools. It is a week-long program where students will make comparisons between the zebrafish and humans. They will capture male and female fish and create a habitat for them. They will harvest the fish eggs and keep them in a petri dish and will observe them transform into embryos. All in a matter of a week.
So we're trying to break down some of the stereotypes that some of these kids have about who a scientist is. They think of Albert Einstein, you know, crazy guy with big hair and a lab coat. And that's kind of a stereotype that a lot of kids we find have. And so we're trying to get them to think, maybe I could become a scientist.
The students were put into groups of four or five and were assigned different roles for working as a team. Once the habitats were created, students then had to capture the fish to put them in their new homes.
Some of us caught the fish and got the water for them because they can't use tap water because they will kill them. So they made special water for them.
I got to catch the female fish. It was crazy because they kept swimming away. Once it got by the wall, I put the net onto the wall and it swam into the net.
Once the male and female were captured and put in their tanks, the students were then instructed to observe them and determine which was the male and which was the female based on some clues they were given earlier.
I think the bigger one's the female, and the smallest one is the male. Because, well, he said usually it's like that.
Why do you say that?
I say the small one.
Because usually in nature, the female is always
the biggest. My hypothesis was that the male fish would be bigger than the female fish because humans, the male, sometimes bigger than the female. But the conclusion was females were bigger because they had to lay eggs, so they had a lot of eggs.
And I just wanted to let you know, your fish are going to be under a container tonight.
Good.
There's a heating pad to keep them warm because remember, they're tropical fish, so they like warm temperatures. What's going to spur them to mate is the change from night to day. So I actually have them on a light cycle. Not all fish will mate because female might not like her male. Sometimes that happens. So if you do not have embryos tomorrow, I will bring some so that every group will have embryos.
I'm really excited about seeing the eggs, like how many eggs fish have, because like fish have lots of eggs, and I'm excited to see how many they made.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Butler.
Guys, you ready to work as scientists today?
Yes!
Thank you.
What are you guys excited to see today?
The babies.
Like, have you been to the right school? guys get embryos?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks. Annie?
Yeah.
I don't know.
We counted six.
Yeah.
That's six.
The orange.
You think they, I don't know if those orange things are really like, because last time
I don't
it was
see
clear.
Any.
Last time they was clear.
Yeah, you don't have any, so you're gonna adopt?
See, those are
these are fish embryos.
Last night I was talking to my dad about how they eat their babies. I don't think that's good, that's being a good parent, because you're just eating your babies. That ain't right.
The male and female fish are then taken out of the individual tanks, and the eggs are harvested. For those whose fish did not produce any eggs, the students were provided with eggs that Miss Butler brought with her.
As a group, we worked together to strain the water that has the embryos in it into over a bucket, into a strainer, and then we put those zebrafish embryos that we've collected in the strainer into a petri dish. And every day they take that petri dish to the microscope that we've brought into the classroom, and they're able to view the development of the living organism, and they develop very rapidly.
We see the eggs and their cells.
Some of them look like
and the yolk.
And so one of them looks like it's like 7.7 hours, or that one, because it's like about to come off the yolk. But then there's like a couple that look like that. But then most of them are just, they just look like regular.
Exactly.
They look like bubbles.
Okay.
Yeah, like little bubble things.
Wow, I see them. Little things.
I saw like these little, well, they kind of look like little crystals to me. Like, you know, the shoe, the stuff that you that comes in the shoes, like the
I think they got 12.
They look like those, but they're really smaller.
While some students were looking at the egg cells in the microscope, others were counting the number of eggs they had in their petri dishes.
30.
Who counted five?
30.
The students would keep count of their eggs for the next 3 days after cleaning the petri dish to see how many eggs survived to day five.
We had 15. We ended up with four.
But yesterday it was five, and it was four, so we must have miscounted or something.
We had 69 embryos, but now we have 15 larvae and 6 embryos.
I think it's kind of amazing how they grow really fast, because human babies don't really grow that fast. And usually it takes like a few months for us to develop, but it doesn't take that much for a zebrafish because they're small.
So the students get very excited to see the different developmental stages of the zebrafish, and by the end of the week they're able to see the heart beating. So you have to understand, this is a 4-day-old zebrafish. It's already developed a beating heart and blood cells that they can visualize through the microscope, and it really excites them a lot.
I see the yolk, and I see some of the little spots that start seeing their stripes, and I see their eyes in their fin.
I can see the heart a little bit, cause it's moving real fast. The eyes is like real, real big.
I see the long fin. And I can see the heart beating.
So what do you think about that? That's a 4-day-old fish.
It is? 4 days? Oh, wow. Yeah. It's really long, too.
I think it's awesome. Yeah, awesome.
Garrett Heights science teacher, Sandra Knutson, is excited that her students had the opportunity to take part in the BioEYES project.
I hope that they become more interested in the hands-on piece, being able to expose them to a lot more of the technology, the experiences of actually using live animals, that it isn't always just the school setting, so that they can see that science is not just what's in a textbook. It is what you make out of it.
This is a program that brings a lot of resources into schools that they don't normally have, and it's a challenging program. Through a donation from the University of Maryland, Baltimore County, we acquired about 30 microscopes, and as I train teachers, I've been giving them microscopes. So we do, in addition to providing the materials such as the microscopes we use during the week that we're there, we've been delivering additional resources to schools. We find that the students really remember the program. So I might be visiting a school from year to year, and when I come back the next year, there are students that have already had the program that recognize me and say, "You're the fish lady." And they get very excited and they tell me how much they love the program. And when are they going to see it again?
I like that I get to see fish and the insides of it, and I get to learn more stuff about it.
What I like about it is the fact that I get to see new fish and I get to see them change and change and change and change until they're a full-grown adult.
I thought this week was exciting, seeing all the zebrafish and seeing the life cycle of it.
I loved what we did this week because when I grow up, I want to be a scientist, and this is like a good jump start for science.